Did some shooting today, about 70 yards, with a couple different bullets, comparing them to some of my reloads. And I wanted to give you guys a look at some of the benefits of reloading, specifically 223. Not only can you save a lot of money reloading, but you can get a lot more accuracy for the price. What I have here are three different groups of some of my reloads with some pretty high-end bullets here, and I'm just using range pickup brass. So I was testing out a load for hunting with a couple different powder ranges. Now my best group is right here. We're not going to go into the powders and why these groups were different, but I just want to show you guys some of the differences between what you can make at home versus what you can buy. So right here, this is not including this right here. This is a 10-round group, and if you were to take the smallest 5-round group out, it's under half an inch at 70 yards. If you're talking about 3-round groups, 0.2 inches. The whole group, from furthest spot to furthest spot, is still less than an inch. So this is a pretty accurate load, and I'm not using store-bought, super nice brass or anything like that. This is just stuff that I put together real quick. So I do bulk reloads in 223 that I just use regular full metal jacket projectiles, 55 grains, instead of buying these, and you can get them for $85 for 1,000 rounds. So that's a really good deal, and they are almost as accurate as these. If a normal person is shooting them both side by side, they would be just as accurate. You wouldn't notice the difference at all. So, to compare to some of the bullets that you might buy in the store, we have 5 rounds of Remington 55 grain pointed soft point. I think these are $20 a box. And it looks like our group here, if you don't count the flyer, is right under an inch. If you count the flyer, almost 2 inches. And then we'll move up the list even higher. We have some 69 grain PPU match ammunition. These are hollow point boat tails. We have an inch there, and a little less than an inch and a half there. These are about the same price, $20 a box. And then we have some Monarch polymer coated steel case, and looks like they are a little more than an inch and a half group on what you can see. I actually had a flyer that was off the paper up here.
So to reload sub MOA bullets will cost you somewhere around 25 to 26 cents a round, depending on the bullets that you're using. Versus if you go out and buy this expensive match grade or hunting ammo, you could spend a dollar a round easy and not get near the accuracy. So, just wanted to show this simple footage right here. Any questions about this video or what's in it, let me know. Make sure you like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Gonna do some shooting here with our Leatherwood Hilux scope, NC Star removable scope mount, and our POF 3.5 pound trigger. Gonna test out some reloads today, and also some special reloads that I have made hunting. So let's go down to our 70-yard table and load up. Okay, let's set a 4X and see if. Oh yeah, sweet.
Hey, that's pretty cool. Check that out. Hopefully you can see the spalling from those bullets hitting that steel plate. Okay, back up here at 70 yards. Gonna go ahead and load our AR-15 up here with some of my bulk reloads, just to verify that we are hitting where we want to hit. And I'm gonna be testing out an aluminum magazine from Palmetto State. I like to load with stripper clips. So all my reloads I actually put on these clips here. It's a lot easier, I think, in the field to carry a ton of stripper clips and a loader spoon and a bunch of magazines, but what do I know? All right, let's give it a try. Okay, there's 20 rounds. Let's go check it out. See where we're hitting. My first group, before I started zeroing, was really nice. It's always good to see when your reloads are accurate. And then I started moving it all around. Target is moving back and forth, so it's going to affect some of my shots, but the target moving around in the wind. All right, so this is three shots here, first group, and then I started moving it around. My final location looks like it's somewhere around here, maybe a little bit low. We have three rounds here, one, two, three. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. I should have had my brass catcher on earlier, but I wasn't paying attention. Okay, we have 30 rounds here, different loads. We've got 25 grains, 24 and a half grains, and 25 and a half. So let's start with the lightest ones here. I'm gonna start with the 24 and a half grain bullets, and that is 24 and a half grains of H335 powder. At all. Okay. All right. Let's see what we can do here. Thank you. pretty good results for this windy day with a moving target. Okay, let's bump it up to 25 grains. All right, 25 grains of H335. Let's see what we can do. Pulled them a little bit, but let's go take a look at that. I am pretty sure that I had better results out of those 25 grain bullets there. Our final hunting load here, 25 and a half grains of H335. With our varmint tip bullets. Okay, here we go. Alright, now we're gonna go. We're gonna be aiming for the bottom left.
Next up, I'm going to try some factory made ammo and see how the accuracy compares to my reloads. We've got some pretty popular stuff here. First up, we're going to test Remington 55 grain PSP. And these can be had anywhere. There's that. Soft point here. We're going to do a five round group of each of these. We have these Remingtons. We also have PPU 223 match grade hollow point boat tail, and these are 69 grains. That's a pretty heavy bullet for the barrel twist that I'm using here. We had a 1 in 9. And then our other, we got some of the new Monarch polymer coated 55 grain. These are hollow points. This is a new bullet that Monarch has come out with, and actually one of the only steel case rounds that this AR will cycle with. Most of the other steel case gets jammed in the chamber, and I end up having to knock it out. So we've got a target set up there at 70 yards. It's about 20 mile an hour constant winds almost, with about 35 mile an hour gusts. So we've got five rounds here. Let's load them up, see what we can hit. I just got through shooting some of my reloads at about an inch, so we know our scope is on. Let's see what we can do here. Okay, there's five rounds of that. We're going to go ahead and move forward to the PPU, shoot five rounds out of that, and then we'll move over to the Monarch, shoot it. Then we'll go down and take a look at all three targets and compare them to some of my reloads. I don't know if you can tell on camera. Let's give them a try. 69 grain projectiles. 1 in 9 twist barrel.
arrow for the center. Okay, it looks like my group opened up a little bit with those heavier bullets. Not that bad. I don't have a target left over down there for these, so we're going to shoot at the little symbol there at the bottom. Get 5 rounds of this Monarch stuff. What's nice about these is they're really cheap because they're steel case, but they're also hollow point. So a lot of ranges that don't allow full metal jacket, you can shoot these here, still shoot for cheap. Okay, give these a try. Okay, let's go check it out. I'll bring these boxes down here with me. So, put a face with a name. Let's go see what we got. So, first up is our Remington soft point bullets. They are here at the bottom right. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Looks like that is a little more than a 2-inch group. And then second, we have our PPU 69 grain match hollow point boat tails. About the same, about a 2-inch group, 5 rounds. And then up here, we have 5 rounds of the Monarch polymer coated steel case hollow points. This was my point of aim, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So about a 3, 3.5 inch group. If you disqualify this flyer here, it brings it in a little bit closer. So just to give you an idea, these are some of my reloads here. That's 10 rounds. That's 10 rounds, not that one. 10 rounds there. So, I don't know. You could buy really expensive bullets and get 2-inch groups with 5 rounds, or you could make your own for a lot less and get a 10 rounds in a 1-inch group. Anyway, if you guys have any questions about these bullets that I shot today, put them in the comments, let me know. I'm gonna go ahead and shoot the rest of these out. Okay, I'm sorry for the windy audio, you guys, but I'm gonna shoot some 223 here, right about 105 yards. Shoot this Remington soft point, which was grouping up 2 inches at 70 yards. Where we're at. Like nothing. So easy with this. Also running this Palmetto State aluminum GI style magazine. Haven't had a single malfunction out of it yet. I really like how lightweight it is, and you know, the slim profile that you get with the GI style mag. It's really nice. Next up is Monarch polymer coated hollow points, 55 grains. These were 2.5 to 3 inch group. 70 yards. Let's see if we can get that steel under 10 rounds. Shoot some steel. see money. In this POF trigger, that scope, man. Like nothing, 100 yards is nothing. All right, let's load up the rest of this 69 grain PPU. All the points. Zero magnification. Wish I had a little bit longer range to go to. It's about as far as I can go though. Alright, that's it. Some 100 yard testing. This stuff was definitely the most accurate. PPU 69 grain. And second place is the Remington. Monarch is good plinking stuff, but as you could expect for a cheap steel case, not the most accurate. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you have questions, put them in the comments.